Okay, this would be 5B, and there goes Commissioner Smith. Okay, next item is 1600 El Camino Real. This is a request for a conditional use permit to allow a secondhand retail establishment within the general commercial zoning district per section 1296.110(c)(1) of the San Bruno zoning ordinance. And this would actually be the Society of St. Vincent de Paul. So, staff report, please.
Thank you and good evening. As stated, the Society of St. Vincent de Paul has applied for a use permit to locate a retail establishment that sells used goods. The site is located on the northeast corner of El Camino Real and San Diego Avenue. The building is approximately 13,000 square feet. A furniture retailer occupied the store, but it has been vacant for the past year. The Society of St. Vincent de Paul is proposing to sell a variety of secondhand goods ranging from furniture, clothing, and everyday household items. Approximately 60% of the first floor area will be dedicated to furniture sales, 15% will be dedicated to clothing sales, and 15% will also be dedicated to household items. The remaining first floor area will be utilized as a sales preparation area. The proposed hours of operation are Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., and Sundays, 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. The applicant has indicated that they will be accepting drop-off donations between the hours of 10 a.m. and 5 p.m. Monday through Saturday, and 11 a.m. and 3 p.m. on Sundays. Staff has added a number of conditions of approval regarding the drop-off donations. Those are specifically conditions number 9, 10, and 11 within the staff report. And essentially, condition number 9 requires daily inspections of the public right-of-way to remove any accumulated drop-off donations, litter, or debris. Failure to do so would result in code enforcement action. Condition number 10 requires the applicant to install 2 exterior cameras along the south side elevation. And condition of approval number 11 requires the applicant to install signage prohibiting after-hour drop-off donations. One thing I would also like to point out is that the Architectural Review Committee did approve an architectural review permit and facade funding to update the exterior appearance of the storefront. That proposal calls for new paint for the entire structure. They will also refurbish the existing roof sign and install new internally illuminated channel lettering on the face of the building. The proposal also includes the painting of the aluminum storefront, and they'll also replace all the existing broken window panes. Staff did send the required 300-foot public notice to property owners within 300 feet of the property, and we did not receive any comments. Overall, staff is supportive of the use permit request. We do find that the proposed use is consistent with other retail establishments along El Camino Real, and will definitely provide a beneficial service to the greater and immediate neighborhood of San Bruno. Additionally, staff finds that the updated facade will also improve the exterior appearance of the structure, which will also benefit the immediate neighborhood and the overall El Camino Real commercial corridor. With that, staff does recommend approval, and we do recommend that the Planning Commission approve the use permit request, subject to conditions of approval 1 through 10 within the staff report. I'm available to answer any questions that you may have. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Matt. Any questions of
Chair?
Mr. Marshall?
Two questions, Matt. One, why did they have, if it was a furniture store before, why do they have to come for a use permit?
Oh, it's because of the sales of used goods. That's strictly why we're here tonight.
Okay, and I'm sure you meant to say conditions 1 through 11. You said 1 through 10, but and on the number 10 that you talked about, does that include the proper lighting so the cameras work? Because I know we have cameras outside of our office, and at night, if the light bulb's turned off, the cameras don't do any good.
Correct, yeah, and what I should point out, one of the conditions of approval within the architectural review permit was to install exterior lighting along the south side elevation. So yes, those cameras okay. will need
lighting. We probably put in number 10 and with lighting to work with the cameras or something?
Yeah,
like that?
We could definitely add that to condition of approval number 10.
Any other questions?
Through the chair.
Mr. Peterson?
I hate to ask this, but on the same condition about the cameras, you can install cameras, but if you don't have any method of recording and retaining the pictures, you don't have anything. So isn't this condition a little short on requirements?
We could definitely add that language that I believe a closed circuit television system be required, and we can coordinate with the police department to determine an appropriate system as well.
Okay.
So we can add that.
I appreciate that. Thank you. Sure. It's just in the past, I mean, the public may not realize it, but in the past, there have been conditions that don't really specify what you expect would happen, and then people don't do anything. And sometimes it's just because they think they're doing what you ask them to do, but it's not clear. So all I'm saying is I appreciate your clarifying it.
Correct.
Thank you.
Any other questions of staff? No? Thanks, Matt. Okay, at this time, would somebody from the St. Vincent de Paul Society like to step up there and give us a brief overview, if you would, please?
Reduced retail.
Good evening, Commissioners. We just want to thank you for this opportunity to present to you what we think is a very exciting undertaking for the Society of St. Vincent de Paul and hopefully for the residents of San Bruno. In these very tough economic times, it's difficult often for St. Vincent de Paul to be able to continue to serve the needs of those that are impacted, the working poor primarily in this area. We've been blessed for many years to have St. Robert's and St. Bruno's conferences in the two Catholic parishes here able to do home visits and to serve and to allow those that have not necessarily the income to purchase items to be vouchered in our stores. We're represented tonight by many of the Vincentians from throughout the county, including three board members and members of our store committee who have experience in running stores throughout the whole county. It's very, I think, important for us to thank you up front for this opportunity to come to San Bruno. And so we're very appreciative of a favorable consideration of this application. I'm not sure if you have any other specific questions, but the stores undertake a lot of our mission and throughout the county. Employment, recycling, the vouchering, and what we like to call treasures or gently used items that are available to the paying public that enable us to offer these options for redemption for our voucher folks. So unless you've got any questions, this is our store operations manager, Oscar Perez, and my name is Lorraine Moriarty, and I'm the executive director of St. Vincent de Paul.
Thank you. Okay, any questions of kind folks from St. Vincent de Paul?
Through the chair.
Commissioner Mary Johnson.
I want to just check with you. I know that I had the opportunity to meet you at the architectural review, but if you can speak to the drop-off, that's an area that I want to be sure that it's noted and the public gets to hear about the drop-off and pick-up. As you know, that it's very common to, when people want to donate, they want to take it directly, but if it's after hours, it certainly can be a place where it's that particular area doesn't have a lot of space and you don't have a huge area for drop-off. And so I'd like if you can please provide us an overview of what that system looks like.
Yes, and I will defer to Oscar Perez, our store operations manager, to share with you how we handle it.
Yes, as far as the drop-offs, I mean, we have a fleet of trucks that goes around also. And if the store were to get an unusually large amount of drop-offs, normally it all gets sorted and it gets put right back into the store immediately. We have staff to sort through everything, but if for some reason we wind up too much, we transfer it over to our other stores. You know, so there's never a buildup of anything, you know. And as far as I know, one of the questions that was brought up earlier too was about like drop off after hours.
Yes.
That happens. You know, that's one of the reasons for the security cameras and the lighting that we're going to be putting out there to try to discourage them. We're also going to put up signage out there discouraging that. But if it does happen, the staff are directed every morning at all our stores to bring everything inside immediately. One of the first things that they do in the morning when they come in, and then we have a truck that goes around every other day to pick up everything that is not usable, and they haul it away.
Okay. Thank you for answering that.
You're welcome.
Through the chair.
Commissioner Pearson.
Trying to take the positive view on that, I'm sure you'll post the hours for dropping off next to the door.
Yes.
Would you also consider possibly putting them on the front of the building, because people go up and down El Camino all day and they don't go down that side street typically. So if they could read the hours on the front of the building, it might help them remember.
No, we can do that. We definitely do that.
That'd be great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good idea. Any other questions? No? Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Okay, at this time, I'll open it up to the public. Anybody from the public wishing to speak on this particular item, step up to the microphone. And seeing none, we'll close it and bring it back to the commissioners for discussion action.
Through the chair.
Commissioner Peterson.
I'd like to move the commission approve use permit 10-24 based on findings of fact 1 through 3 and conditions of approval 1 through 11 with an additional condition 12 that the drop-off hours and days be placed on a sign on the front of the building also.
And revised 10.
Excuse me?
And a revised 10.
Right.
revised number 10.
Oh, and revised number 10, yes.
I'll second it.
Okay, we have a motion and a second. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed? Nope. There are none. Congratulations. There is a 10-day appeal period. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Through the chair.
Commissioner Peterson.
Can you tell us when you might be opening?
All right. 11 days.
You guys.
11 days.
Let's just say I've got my shopping list of what I need together already. So we want to get this open as soon as possible.
Thank you.
So we're going to get to work right away on
everything. Thank you.
Excellent.